Hello everyone, and thank you for watching this video. This is a very short video on risk management. The purpose is just to introduce you to the concept of risk management, the need for risk management, how risk management adds value, quickly touching upon how risk management could be a good career opportunity. And if you want to know more about risk management, go ahead and attend our course. It's a great course, ISO 31000 2-day, very practical, very hands-on. And one of the few courses I've seen which takes theory, applies it to real life. We have a real life case study of a real situation, something that I think you could be very familiar with. And what I really enjoy is to see how a concept of risk management, a theoretical concept, pretty dry in many ways, can actually be applied. And you'll see the value that you can get in real life by applying this. When I give my card to people, often they say, well, okay, you do risk management. That's interesting. Good choice. And the answer is, yes, it is. But why? To me, what makes risk special is you can apply it to real life. You can apply it to personal life. You can apply it to your official life. You can make a career of it, as I have, as many others have, and it's a great career. It's a career that actually gives you a pretty good understanding of the full organization. And not many people will have that understanding, I assure you. So what is risk? It's defined as the effect of uncertainty on objectives. That's the definition from the ISO 31000, the ISO standard from the International Standards Organization, Switzerland. The 31000 is the standard on risk management. And what's nice about this is most other standards which need risk management actually refer to this standard again. So in many others, like the Business Continuity Standard 22301, Information Security 27001, Environment, health and safety, 14,000, 18,000, 9,000. Most of them say that you need to do your risk management in line with ISO 31000 principles. Therefore, our ISO 31000 course is a great one to attend. And as you see in this photograph, we have this climber climbing this rock face. Well, why is this person climbing this cliff? Many reasons. Maybe it's the adrenaline. He just enjoys it. He enjoys the challenge. He set himself a goal that he wants to meet. Maybe he's been challenged. It's a bet. He wants to win that bet. Surely there's a reason. By climbing this cliff, is he taking on risk? Is he in danger? Is there a possibility of danger? Is he more at danger here than maybe on plain ground down below? Possibly, yes. But he's doing it, and he's doing it for a reason. The important part is he seems to be thinking it through. So he seems to have safety equipment. He's got a harness. He's got various things. He's got those buckles which allow him to strap himself in. He's probably got a couple of those nails which he can drive into the wall to get some leverage. So he seems to be pretty well prepared, and I think he seems to have done his risk management. So best of luck to him. Now, let's take that parallel to real life. And this is one of the sayings I really like from our course. You can build a ship, but you can keep it in harbor. Why? Because there's a risk that it may sink. A ship in harbor is safe, yes, but that's not what ships are built for. Ships are built for going on the sea, to take people to various places, perhaps to transport equipment and cargo. The point is you built the ship, you want to do that work, you'll have to take the risk. Let me use an example, a more exciting example. You buy a lovely red Ferrari and you put it key, you keep it in a garage all through because you say, if I take it out, it could have an accident. There's a possibility. I'd rather not face that possibility and let me keep it in the garage. Sure, you can look at it, you can feel happy, but is that really why you bought the car? You probably bought the car to take it out, to enjoy it, to drive it, and maybe for others to see it and get envious. That could well be. So the point is, if you do want to do smart things, you want to do great things, you want to do exciting things, you want to do them for the first time, you want to feel good about achieving something that's not been done before, you'll have to take a risk typically. So the smart thing is to manage that risk. Don't just take the risk on its own. Be smart about it. Take a calculated risk and try and think through what can go wrong and try and mitigate it before you jump into it. That's really what smart risk management is all about. And that's really what the ISO 31000 preaches. And that's what we teach in our course. Typically, what do we cover in the course? The whole range of possible risk management issues. Types, sources, exposure, consequences, risk cause, risk factor, what else you need to keep in mind, as you build your risk readiness, your risk framework. We'll cover the three pillars of the ISO 31000 principles, framework, process. A quick slide to cover all three. The 8 principles of risk management, the principles that you abide by. So if you're not seeing this happening, then maybe you're not getting the full value. So it's worth circling back to these and say, what else should I do so that I get the benefits of my efforts? Pillar 2 framework, how do you design your framework? What do you put in place? How do you monitor, measure, evaluate, and keep improving? So it keeps getting better and better. And therefore you increase the value. Sometimes we use the phrase, Rome wasn't built in a day. It takes centuries, years. In this case, don't take years, maybe take less, but start, make a beginning, keep improving, and keep getting better and better. And lastly, the nuts and bolts of risk management, the process. Identifying your risks, analyzing your risks, evaluating your risks, prioritizing them, putting in place risk treatments. So your initial framework of making sure that you have all the right elements in view and being monitored and measured, recorded and reported, communicated and consulted across all levels of the organization. So you're all on the same page. Sometimes we say we've used the collective wisdom of the organization. So take all relevant perspectives, consider those, and use that to build your risk management process. So all three pillars are now in place. Perform your risk assessment, create your risk appetite tables, do a traffic lighting of what's concern that you need to fix further and what's under control that you need not worry about. Now, in our course, we actually take this further. So this is mostly what we cover on day one, according to the ISO 31000. And then day two is a case study, practically full day. And there we use a real life example. So there we have, as a case study, we've chosen the development of the Boeing Dreamliner aircraft. As I said, it's a real life aircraft. It flies. I've flown it myself. And it's quite exciting when I'm sitting in that to say, I now have knowledge of how this whole process happened and what went right and what went wrong. So that's what we use as our case study. So maybe just to show you a short video that we typically introduce the case study with.
The Boeing 787 Dreamliner has had the most successful new aircraft launch in commercial aviation history. And for good reason. It's a super efficient airplane that applies the most advanced technologies in aerospace.
And innovation happens at different levels. It can be individual parts on the airplane, and it can be the whole airplane itself, the 787 being a good example.
So as we just saw in the previous slides, if you're innovating, you're doing things for the first time, you're a first mover, almost certainly you'll take on risk. So what we do in our case study is really see what risks Boeing took on in order to develop this new aircraft. Did it all go according to plan? What went well? What didn't go well? What they should have foreseen? What they did foresee? How did things end up? So every time I teach this case study, it's really exciting because not many times have I seen courses where you're applying theory to a real life situation. So that's certainly for me is a lot of fun. What we do as we work our way through the case study is then plot the various risks that we can identify in the development of the Boeing Dreamliner, possibilities, what could go wrong, a whole bunch of possible threats. So let's identify those. Let's then analyze those. What's so significant? What's not so significant? What do we need to worry about? What do we not need to worry about? And then compare them with our benchmark. How much is reasonable? What's our risk appetite? What level are we okay with? What's less than that, we don't need to worry about too much. Let's assume those are manageable. What's more than that certainly is of concern, and we would need to do something to bring down that level of concern. So let's put in place certain risk treatments. So I hope that gives you a good idea of the course that we offer, the coverage, and what makes it very different and very special. We get great customer feedback on this, and I think it really gives you a good sense of how to approach risk management, how risk management can add huge value. And if you choose a career in risk management, how it can make you a very integral part of the organization. To grow, they need you. Because each organization that grows takes on risk, and each organization that takes on risk would be smart to to have smart people manage that risk. I think it's a good long-term career to be in. So with that, I'm going to wind up this video. All the best. I hope you enjoy the course. And feel free to get in touch if you need something else. Take care. Have a good day. Bye-bye.